My computer won't start, it won't boot, there's a black screen every time I hit the power button. What can I do to solve this problem? Now, we're gonna go through the most obvious one first, which is the most common when I sell a PC. I actually get quite a few people that message me saying there's a black screen, it won't start. So this problem is easy to fix if it is this problem, and that is, first thing you have to do is take the little battery out. So make sure the power is disconnected from the PC and press the power button a few times just to drain all the power. Then I want you to take out this little circular battery and then leave it out for about 20 seconds. I usually find that's long enough to reset the whole PC. You can leave it out for a minute if you want to, just to be sure. And also you may have to take out your graphics card for this as well. In this case, we can just pull it out since there's no screws attached, but you may have to unscrew the graphics card and take it out and then put it back in because the little battery may be underneath the graphics card. Now, once you've done this, put your battery back in. If you have to reconnect your graphics card, then go do that as well. And then I want you to make sure that your monitor is plugged off of the graphics card, not the actual motherboard itself. So a lot of people will get the PCs and then they'll plug their motherboard, will have a what's called a display out, and they'll plug it off the motherboard and they'll get a black screen when they're meant to be plugging it off the graphics card. Or of course, if the PC's BIOS has been trained to work off the motherboard and not the graphics card, when they go to plug the monitor off the graphics card, it also gives out a black screen. So essentially resetting the whole PC by doing this and then putting the graphics card back in and then plugging your monitor off the graphics card will train the computer from the get-go to work off the graphics card, which is definitely what you want, especially if you're on a gaming PC or you're using multiple monitors from the graphics card drivers. So that is the most common problem when your computer won't start and you have a black screen. However, there are some other problems, and recently there's been two computers that have come to me, especially this one on the desk here, which is now the fourth time this PC is coming back. And I'm gonna talk to you guys about the more rarer problems that can occur and how you can fix them right after this sponsor spot. Did you just shriek because you saw the price of Windows 10 Pro Key licenses online?
Yes.
Well, shriek no longer. With today's video sponsor, SCD Keys, you can get a Windows 10 Pro single user and license activated for as little as $14 using the coupon code BFTYC. Links in description below. Welcome back to Tech Yes City, and right here we'll give you guys a rundown of this computer on the desk. This is actually a different PC to the one I initially sold. So when I sold this PC the first time around, it was working. It had a 1050 Ti, it had 8 GB of RAM and a 4570. And when it came back, the computer was completely gone. So it wasn't even booting. And I was sort of scratching my head because these PCs that I sell on the lower end here, they're actually very sturdy because they're ex-business, like high-end business server PCs that people use for 24/7 reliability. So it's kind of rare for a PC like this that's come out of the studio and it's fully working to then come back a week later and it's completely gone. There's not even intermediate faults, it's just gone. So what ended up happening was that computer had a faulty power supply. And because I didn't have time, I ended up just saying, look, there's probably something else going on here. So I replaced the whole PC for the person until I could have time to inspect the original PC. So that person then got the replacement PC with everything changed. Everything had been changed on this PC. They then came back to me another week later and said, this PC, something's not working. It's giving me out a black screen. And I knew, okay, this is very weird. And what had happened was the graphics card, that's the thing I'm holding in my hand right now, there's two of them actually, it ended up being toast. It was gone. There was no bringing this thing back. And so I thought, okay, perhaps he got unlucky and the graphics card was on its way out. So I then replaced it just to check. I then put in, instead of a 1050 Ti, I put in a GTX 750 just to check, because if he's got something wrong on his end, bringing back the PC constantly and me fixing it isn't gonna fix the actual issue. So I put in the GTX 750, and sure enough, another week later, the PC came back and this GTX 750 I'm holding in my hands is now kabonkers. It is gone. And this is one of those things where, okay, at this stage, I'm actually gonna be charging to fix this PC because I know it's not a problem on my end. So I've told them, look, we're putting in now a GT 740, until they fix their issue. And I said to the person who bought this PC, I said, look, there is something going on at your house. And they admitted to me that their dishwasher had recently failed as well. And so I'm thinking to myself, okay, well, what it is in this case was I've come into this problem twice in the past. Once was when I was living in Japan, and that was that the PowerPoint that you're plugging into wasn't grounded properly. And what this does on most devices is it will create a discharge. And so for instance, if you're connecting something that's plugged in to something, another device that perhaps is grounded, then there can be an initial discharge from that cable that you're connecting to the said PC device. And so the easiest way to check for this is, especially if it's a HDMI cable, so you're plugging in a monitor that is not grounded properly to say a computer that you've just set up and you haven't turned on yet, the easiest way to check is just to touch the tip of the HDMI cable. And so if you get a shock from that, do make sure that you're inserting your graphics card and it's a non-discharge cable, in that both your monitor and your PC PowerPoints are grounded properly. And in terms of grounding, all that means is that there's an extra point in the power line that goes to the actual earth, inside the earth, and it lets out all the discharge into the earth. So it's important to do this for PC parts, otherwise parts can be overloaded. And with PC parts, they can quickly become toast if they're overloaded. And so in this case, with this PC right here, I definitely want the said person to fix up their problems before I'm sending out the PC again, because a PC having faults every single week definitely spells something seriously wrong on the said person's PowerPoint. Perhaps that particular PowerPoint that they're plugging the computer off just wasn't grounded properly, and the same for the dishwasher, but other PowerPoints in their house were grounded correctly. So that's something to look out for that can be a weird issue, but can definitely cause you damage financially, because it's gonna cost you money to replace the said parts. So the next problem is interrelated. I'm actually gonna put out two recommendations here, and that is actually becoming increasingly more common, and that is faulty CPUs on older gear. So I recently had a friend who came over with a PC, and he said, Brian, can you help me fix this computer up? It's just, it boots, and then it just, as it's going to Windows, it just gets a complete black screen. And I was like, okay, that's really weird. But because it's doing this problem consistently, I had a suspicion that it was actually either the power supply or the CPU. And so we tried a different power supply and it still did that same problem. But then after that, I actually changed the CPU out, and it was an i5-2400. And I changed it out for a spare i5-2400 that I had on hand. And sure enough, that fixed the problem straight away. So basically this i5-2400 CPU that we're using had been used for so long that it just had degraded over time, to the point where it was failing to boot to Windows properly. And so what happens on this case, especially if it's a PC where you can't get into the BIOS, you sometimes can't change the said default voltages. But if you're on an aftermarket vendor board like a Zeus, MSI, ASRock, or Gigabyte, sometimes you can go into the BIOS and change the voltage settings and up the voltages, even just 5% across the board, and that can prolong the life of your CPU. But on the back of that, DDR3 memory or DDR4 memory, this stuff can be faulty, and actually it's one of the most commonly faulty parts that I come into on PCs. However, I find with RAM, if it is faulty, it'll either do two things, and that is a faulty stick of memory, the computer just won't boot at all. But if it's faulty to the point where it can still boot, usually the behavior will be erratic and unpredictable, in that you may make it to Windows sometimes, you'll boot up a program, the whole PC will turn off, or sometimes a program will crash, or sometimes the PC will just freeze upon booting and give you the said black screen. But in this case, if you want to check if your computer is faulty because of DDR3 memory, and especially if you open the PC up and you see there's two sticks of memory, you can just take out one stick at a time and alternate your usage on the computer between those sticks of memory, and that should give you an idea if perhaps one of the sticks of memory is faulty. And now it's time for the last problem, and I'm mentioning this one last because it is, in my opinion, the most rarest problem that I've come into. I've only ever come into this once, where a power supply is faulty, but it passes all the power good tests absolutely fine. So all the lights light up, the power supply tester is showing that this power supply should be good, but then you boot it up and you get stuck on Windows, things freeze, and things just don't work properly in general. So typically, if you have a faulty power supply, things probably just won't boot up at all, or you won't even make it to the BIOS screen. But in this case, if you do have a faulty power supply, but it's not showing up any initial symptoms, it can be one thing to try and change, especially if it is from a no-name brand and you've never heard of that power supply before, or you check the price on that power supply online and it's a very cheap power supply. So in this case, I always do recommend, if you're using a PC, especially if you're serious about gaming, then you should step things up and get a decent power supply, at least one from a reputable manufacturer. Anyway, guys, with that aside, I hope you enjoyed today's video on how to fix a PC that won't boot or just gets a black screen. Another thing that you can try too is, if your PC has a speaker on it, then you can usually listen to the PC, and if it's booting to Windows, but it's still giving you a black screen, it can mean that the PC is working normally, but it's just the graphics card or maybe the HDMI cable or something like that isn't working properly. So in that case, an easy way, even if you don't have a speaker, an easy way is to test if the computer's working fine still, but it's just, say, the graphics card, or in the graphics card pipeline, is to turn the computer on and then leave it for about 30 seconds or even a minute, and then press the power button again and see if it cycles down normally. And so that means if you press the power button, even when the computer's on, especially in Windows 10, it'll just automatically start turning the computer off for you. But however, there is a few seconds delay there before the whole system shuts off. And so that can give you an indication if the computer is generally working fine versus something that's wrong from the get-go with, say, the motherboard, the RAM, or the CPU. But I will refer you guys, if you want some more tips and tricks on how to fix some weird problems, I'll refer you to another video that I made. But besides that, it's always a good thing to have a little speaker on your PC. And if you're getting beep codes that are outside the ordinary beep code, that can also tell you problems with your computer, and you can refer to the original manufacturer's guide. But speaking of questions, we do have here the question of the day, which comes from Randy Sprouse, and they ask, as much as I like your content, I have to ask a difficult question. Aren't you driving up PC part prices with your reselling? So to answer this question directly, it's a good question. I'm happy to answer questions like this. You haven't been rude at all or anything like that. You're just asking a question, man. So I'm more than happy to answer that. And basically, I think that we don't use PC resellers don't drive up prices. We actually bring prices down because we're competing with new sales, which those parts are manufactured at a constant supply rate. Usually they're manufactured at a constant supply rate. So me reselling a used PC is not only beating out the retailers, where you're keeping the retailers' prices in check with used PC resales, but you're also taking away from that demand for new parts, which essentially will bring the prices down. However, on the flip side, since I am buying used PC parts off the market, I can be raising the prices of those. So that's why I've always said in the past that the used market's a great thing, because it does work well with the new parts, and it keeps both in a great balance for the tech enthusiast or even someone who just wants to get into the land of PC gaming. Hope that answers that question. I'll catch you guys in another tech video very soon. If you stayed this far and you're enjoying that Tech Yes City content, be sure to hit that sub button, ring that bell, and I'll catch you in the next one. Peace out for now. Bye.